Hello again from the Bureau. I'm Adam Morgan, and I'm joined today by Dr. Andrew Watkins, one of our senior climatologists. Hi, Andrew.
Hey, Adam.
Now, Andrew, we've seen a big change in the weather patterns across Australia during January, certainly with much more rainfall for some parts. And if we have a look at the satellite imagery right now, we can see broad areas of cloud across the tropics, which really is the source for a lot of that rainfall. Still, though, we've still got a lot of bushfires going about the southeast, particularly still some uncontrolled ones around the ACT and southern New South Wales, and even some extreme to catastrophic fire danger through the west of the country as well today. But Andrew, what did we see during January for rainfall in Australia?
Well, we certainly saw a big change from those very dry conditions we saw through much of 2019. We've seen a bit more wetter conditions over in Western Australia, but in the east, unfortunately, still very patchy. Some areas got good rainfall during January, but a number of areas, unfortunately, missed out.
Even with that patchy rainfall, Andrew, it's still looking much more typical than those really dry maps of rain that we saw during last year, isn't it?
Yeah, well, it certainly is, and that's been because we've seen quite a change in our climate drivers over the last few months. If we have a look at what's been going on, in terms of the Indian Ocean Dipole, one of the strongest on record in 2019, that pushed our rain-bearing weather systems off towards Africa, kept us very dry. Now, that pattern has gone back to normal now. We're seeing a neutral Indian Ocean Dipole. And likewise, with the southern annular mode, last year we had a negative southern annular mode. Negative SAM had our weather systems further north than normal. And again, that's broken down during January, and our weather systems have headed back to the south where they should be.
It really was a notable change during the middle of the month when those highs dropped further south. But we were starting to see, even at the peak or the height of the dryness and the bushfire crisis towards the end of 2019, we were starting to see indications that the patterns were going to change. This is our rainfall outlook that we issued at the start of December for January. And already it was looking much more neutral than it had been in previous months.
Yeah, well, certainly well before those drivers broke down, we're seeing quite a patchy outlook for January, a little bit towards the wetter side there in WA, but again, quite patchy in the east. Not a strong outlook for significantly above or below average rainfall anywhere, really.
And that patchy rain that hasn't made, or the rain that we did see in the east and even those areas that did see above average rainfall, it hasn't really made that much of a difference at all to our drought conditions, has it?
No, it certainly hasn't. If we look at the rainfall deficiencies, the drought map from last year, you can see large areas of the Murray-Darling Basin in significant and serious and severe rainfall deficiencies compared to this year. Once we've had that extra January rainfall added in, unfortunately, hasn't really changed that map all that much at all. New South Wales and the Murray-Darling Basin, yet again, had a below average rainfall month.
And our rainfall deficiencies map will remain of interest as we head into the coming weeks with more rain on the way towards the end of this week, and it could be significant. We'll see some rain develop through southern parts of Queensland by midweek, and then towards the weekend or later in the week, we'll see a coastal trough develop along the northern New South Wales coast. And so with those moist northeasterly winds coming in off the Tasman Sea and an upper trough focused over western New South Wales, all the ingredients are there to see some significant rainfall over several days, particularly focused along that coastal fringe. So please keep an eye out for all the latest forecasts and warnings as we head in towards the weekend. But Andrew, thanks for joining us today. It's been a great chat to look at back at what's happened and why that's happened. And please stay in touch with the Bureau, as I said, as we head into the weekend for all the latest information on the upcoming rain.